Crane, you there?
Hey, what's up, Spike?
Just FYI, if you need me, I'll be at the ferry station helping Morgan prep the barge.
Yeah. Yeah. I a plane. I thought an airdrop was on its way, so I came out to look.
Come on. Let me catch my breath now.
Thank you. apostles now? If there are demons, there must be angels.
Somebody's in the school. Our scouts spotted people entering the building.
Don't you worry. As long as we're here keeping an eye on everything, no one will get through.
Thank you.
Is the call. Thank God you're one of the living. Hey, thanks. I'm getting out of here.
Okay, Doc. Here comes your chunk of zombie guts.
Hey, open up in there.
Who are you?
Crane, from the tower. I heard a woman screaming.
Yeah, it's my wife. She's giving birth.
Oh, shit. Is there anything I can do?
We need alcohol to disinfect. Please, help us.
Alcohol? Yeah, I've got some alcohol.
Thank you. Oh, this is gonna be a big help. But, is that all you could find? It's not really enough. I'd go out myself, but I can't leave my wife now.
Let me see if I can find some more. Hey, it's Crane. I found some more.
Yeah! Great, because we're going through it like water. But, is that it? It's almost enough, but not quite.
You must have a lot of germs in there.
Oh, with this terrible plague, everything has to be clean. Spotless! I can't risk my newborn getting infected. We must have more alcohol.
The disease is actually transferred from a bite that causes... Hey, I've got the alcohol. Everything okay in there?
Oh, you got some more?
Yeah, here.
Oh, cheers. Bye.
I could let it go, but I don't think I'm going to.
least if we drink away.
Crane, come in, come in. Did you get the samples I asked for? Excellent, excellent. I was just telling Dr. Camden about...
Hello, Mr. Crane. Glad to have you working with us. You sound like an impressive individual.
Interesting stuff, what passes for blood in this creature. Photosensitive. quite deadly if used on a weapon, I'd wager. But I digress. My last bit of reagent here, and a reserve vial of... Oh, my word. This tissue, it's testing positive for the recombined virus. Camden, do you know what this means?
The meat experiment worked.
When I dosed the meat samples with the altered strain, it's had an effect. This could explain all the different mutations. But I can't. Camden could. He has the equipment. But we have no way to get the research to him.
Well, you can talk to him on the radio. Why not share the info that way?
There's too much data, Crane. It would take years. We'd both be dead and gone before he finished.
Water, water everywhere, and not a drop to drink.
What if I delivered this stuff to you, Dr. Camden? By hand. The data and the tissue samples both.
Crane, getting from there to here would be insanely dangerous.
Yeah, but it could mean a cure, right?
You don't know how much this means, dear boy. To me, to all of us. I'll contact you when everything's ready. You must go now. Much to do. Much to do.
Wait, you what? Fucking hell, Raheem, that was my job!
Oh, right, because you're more qualified to handle explosives than I am. You're just a goddamn tourist. But listen, we messed up. Messed up bad.
All right, what happened? Where are you?
We're on the overpass, and it's all going to shit.
Listen, head to the train yard. Find a place to hide. I'm on my way.
Behind you! Behind you!
Raheem! Raheem! Damn it.
Brecken, do you copy?
Yeah, I copy. What is it?
I'm on my way to get Raheem.
Raheem? He's here in the tower.
No, he's not. He and Omar went to blow that nest, and now they're in trouble.
Like, what? Fuck! Where'd they get the explosives?
Well, Look, I stole them from Ryze.
Oh, Jesus, sake, you Christ!
I'm close. I'll get him to safety, Brecken.
You damn well better. You save him, you hear me? You save him so I can kick his fucking ass! Does Jake know about this?
No, she doesn't.
For God's sake, don't tell her. She'll go out looking for him. And I don't need her getting herself killed, too. God damn it!
You, Tolga?
He wants to talk to us.
Well, I don't want to talk to him. I repeat, you are ordered to come immediately. That is all.
Shut off the radio!
Right! I just want to talk.
Try listening. The first bullet goes over your head. The next one goes through it.
Stop it, Edward. You don't want to scare off someone who might be willing to help us.
We don't know this arsehole from a plate of falafel.
Don't argue with me. Let him in.
Seems Errol wants to talk to you.
There won't be any trouble.
Do I look worried?
Scared to death.
He's perceptive. Come in, come in. I'm Errol.
Kyle Crane.
This is my niece, Salier, and her son, Aaron. Do forgive Edward, but he's completely right to be worried. We're being pursued by some very ruthless men.
There's something oddly familiar about you.
There should be. The campaign spent a lot of money putting my face all over town.
Of course, you're Errol Asani, governor of the province.
Governor of nothing, but Rise has decided that any political figure is a threat to him. So he's ordered my execution. They nearly killed me once already. That's how I lost my leg. And it seems they haven't given up. A squad of his thugs has tracked me to my last safe house in the slabs. Edward was just there. He says they're searching the area. It's only a matter of time before they show up here.
Sounds like you got quite a problem.
I would pay you very well to resolve it.
You know, people say that a lot to me.
Trust me. What I can offer you can't be found anywhere else, at any price.
And I'll think about it. Hey boys, what are we into this time?
Do you understand what a battery is?
Tolga, you're overwhelming him. Inside the engine compartment of a bus is a heavy rectangle.
I know what a battery is.
Okay, we need bus batteries with marine-grade plates and rated at 1300 CCA or better.
CCA means cold cranking amps.
Obviously.
That's a pretty big battery.
Yes, easily 50 to 55 kilograms each.
That's equal to several large rocks. He's American. The metric system makes him angry.
We will need three of them.
Oh, you can use your brute strength. We know you primitives are keen to show how strong you are, to demonstrate physical prowess.
You think it will attract females?
Ugly and stupid. What else does he have?
How does he live like that?
Who knows? You have your instructions. Go do your, interpretation of them.
Thank you.
That's Kareem on the radio.
Ah!
Get your asses back here, then. Screw the state five. Come in through the basement. Is that you, Ozan?
Thank you. We cut power to the left, Karim, just in case.
Karim, it's Crane. Drop your weapon or you're dead.
What the hell's your problem? This doesn't concern you.
Sorry, Karim, but Errol Asani is my concern.
You're working for him? You're a fool. I was his bodyguard, okay? After everything got fucked up and they built the wall, we got overrun. He got bitten on the leg. I took him to Randall, the only doctor I knew in the slums, and we cut it off, clean. It was the only way. He would have turned if we hadn't done it. But the stubborn bastard never forgave us. So, we parted ways.
So why are you trying to track him down now?
Early on, the authorities evac'd all the political bigwigs out of the zone. Errol told us there was a chopper on the way to take us out with him. Then he got bitten. And with all the shit that happened after that, we missed the flight. But after you turned on the transmitter, we heard Errol asking for evac. And a couple of days ago, somebody responded. From outside. The old bastard's got a flight out, and I want a seat on it.
All right, what about Rice? Does he care about this guy?
Not a rat's ass. This was my business. I just want to get out of Haran.
Yeah, well, looks like you won't be making that flight, huh?
That had already dawned on me. But I'd like to walk out of here.
Look, if I see you again, I'm gonna assume the worst. You got it?
Fair enough. Good luck, Crane. You're going to need it.
you find them?
Yeah, I did. Kareem's take on losing your leg was a bit different than yours.
So, you talked to him. Edward was right. You do talk too much. You should leave the talking to people like me, and I'll leave the killing to people like you. However, Kareem was my bodyguard. He allowed me to get bitten, but I don't really blame him for that.
Hey, he saved your life.
By hacking off my leg? The morning I was bitten was the same day they began dropping suppressants. You understand? I told him the antizin drops would begin within hours. All they had to do was wait. Instead, he listened to that idiot doctor of his, and Kareem held me down as the butchers chopped off my leg. Now he thinks I should fly him out of here.
Oh, I told him that's not gonna happen.
You should have killed him.
How about you leave the killing to people like me, huh?
Quite right. I can get you out of here, Crane.
Maybe I like it here.
More likely you've made your own arrangements. Well, they won't work. You've been bitten. I can see it in your eyes. You'll never get past the NCOR quarantine.
Past what?
You see, you have no idea what's going on in the real world. Whoever you think you know, they're not political. And that's the only thing that's going to work now. You don't believe me? Then think of it as an ace up your sleeve, a backup plan. In case you haven't noticed, things don't always work out the way they're supposed to in this town.
Right. If I'm interested, what happens next?
Two things. The first is we need to paint some markers on the rooftop. There's no paint around here, so you'll have to go out and find some. And the second thing is... well, let's just say you'll be leaving here in a better way than when you arrived. Now, go find some paint. There's a construction site.
Idea what they wanted.
Nothing good for sure.
Alright, the roof's been painted.
Good. Now there is one last thing. There's a duffel bag in a locker on the second floor. I'd like you to bring it to me. Since you'll probably open it, there's no point trying to hide the fact that there's $24.7 million inside it. One third of it is yours, if you can bring it back.
Why doesn't Edward get it?
There are too many biters there. I can't risk losing him. We'd be completely defenseless.
And this money's yours?
Most of the bank's depositors are no longer human. Stealing from them isn't a crime. Why have you never once taken the wallet off a biter that you've beaten to death?
Okay, I'll recover the bag, but there's no calling in the evac until I say so. When I bring back the money, I'm taking the radio.
That is unacceptable.
Yeah, but you'll accept it anyway because you have no choice.
You're worse than Kareem. Very well. I accept your terms.
Empty, of course.
Sorry, Crane. I had no choice.
Kareem said I was a fool to trust you.
It's not what you think. I was. you are, but they knew. And they said you were a no-go. So I had to send you on that phony money run. There is no money, at least not worth mentioning. I'm sorry, Crane, but I've got to get my family out of here. Go to the rooftop, and you'll find some things you can use. It's not what I promised, but it's the best I can do. Thank you for what you did for us, Crane. Good luck.
Crane, how's your day been?
Hey, I thought we had an understanding.
I think we have a better understanding now. But if you want to shoot me...
Another time, maybe.
He did leave you a few goodies. I was going to nick him, but I thought, no, Crane's order. Let him have
them. You're almost okay, Kareem.
Almost. Until next time.
Good luck, Kareem.
Exactly.
friendly face for a change. We'd be a bloodstain if you hadn't come along.